Welcome, everyone. This is Jenkins Governance Board Meeting. It's the 17th of April, 2023. Thanks for being here. Topics, I've got news, action items, and budget and expenses, and then CDF topics. Any other topics that need to go on to the governance agenda today? Okay, great. So let's highlight in the news topics, new LTS has been delivered, and we've started removal of a very old major component to be replaced by standard JavaScript. Thanks to Tim Jacome, to Basil Crow, to Jan Farachik, to Alex Brandis, to others. Uli, I believe you've even contributed one or two on these. Thanks very, very much. Exciting to see. We've also got good results on Google Summer of Code. We're in the midst of reviewing those. Early May, our package will be submitted to Google, and they'll then announce how many projects were approved, et cetera. Last item of news, May 8th and 9th in Vancouver, Canada, will be CDCon, sponsored by the Continuous Delivery Foundation and coincident with GitOpsCon. And so a conference there. The Jenkins Awards will be announced there. Any questions on the news items? Okay, next topic. Document Easy CLA. No progress and no requests. Oh, excuse me. Okay. The other, submit pull requests to combine subprojects and SIGs. I've started it. And there are 4 pull requests submitted to begin small incremental steps to retire inactive SIGs. Then I'll do roadmap update pull requests later. So this one is in progress. On retire the Chinese Jenkins site, we're making progress there that it's no longer available on the top level site. And next stop still is further work to do a full redirect from the www.jenkins.io/zh to the root. But that'll need some infra work, and we're tracking that in a help desk ticket. Any questions on those items? Okay, next item was archiving meeting notes. And here we had an open question where to put them, but we don't have an answer from Oleg. I propose we just accept that we'll place them in Jenkins-infra as recommended by many people in the comments on the help desk ticket. Any objections from others? Uli, are you okay with that?
Yes, this makes sense to put it there.
Okay. Daniel, any objections from you?
When you say many people, who suggested that? I mean, I realize that I'm arguing against myself because I requested Jenkins Infra originally. But yeah, I'm not sure how many others agreed.
Damien agreed with the recommendation. I believe I also saw a comment from Alex agreeing with the recommendation. And I'm fine with the recommendation. And I think Uli said he's fine with it. So I think we should just simplify our lives, go ahead with Jenkins Infra and get this one off the list so that we're done with it.
Right. It's not like we cannot move after the fact.
Absolutely. Right. It's a repository. It's very mobile if we need it. So any objections from you, Daniel?
No.
Okay, great. Last action item. This one was just added last week or 2 weeks ago. I need to schedule a retrospective on our certificate renewal process because it was too filled with bumps and bruises for our Linux users and too full of very, very nervous, very last minute changes for the Windows users. Windows users didn't see the problem, but the people who were generating were very nervous that we weren't going to get it done on time. So we've got things to improve there. Any questions on the signing certificate renewal process and its retrospective? Okay, next topic then, budget and expenses. So we've got two outstanding expense items that haven't been reimbursed. One of them has had a request submitted. Vadek Folonier submitted a request many months ago for reimbursement of $52.99. Been approved, but he's not received the funds yet. So I propose that we take that this one becomes an action item for me to figure out why Vadek's not getting reimbursed and what it will take for me to be reimbursed for the $1,500 that I spent for the code signing certificate. We have funds, and I've sent the request to the Jenkins board mailing list asking for everyone's explicit approval. I think it's okay. Uli, I can ask here, are you okay approving that expense here?
Yes, I sent a mail already to you or to the.
Oh, good.
I replied to this mail, but I'm approving it again here. That's fine.
Great. Thank you.
And I'm not sure where do we get the money from, or where do we need to make it? I'm not sure. Where is it?
Yeah, so the money actually sits at on the crowdfunding account at Linux Foundation. And right now there's this $10,000 that's in that account with a nice track record of receiving steady, small contributions from various places. We haven't spent money from it for quite a while. And part of that is because it's been surprisingly difficult to get the funds out of it. So I have the action item, I think, to work with the Continuous Delivery Foundation and with the Linux Foundation to understand what we can do to make this easier. Daniel, any concerns from you about the reimbursement request and the expenses there?
Nope, go ahead.
Great, okay. Thanks, so then I'm going to put that as an action item. And I'm a personally interested action item because I want to get reimbursed.
But you know how or what the next steps are, how to get the money. Okay.
I've sent the request to the people who are the best hope.
Okay.
I think we actually use an Expensify account, or Linux Foundation uses an Expensify account and somehow works it through that. But I've asked them for the details. Mm-hmm. All right, and last topic was from the CDF side. Linux Foundation has an analytics thing that they use called Insights. And that Insights is intended to be a replacement for the DevStats statistics gathering system that they created several years ago and that we've been using to collect data, that I've been using to collect data on how the Jenkins community is doing. So this DevStats conversation includes the list of the five items that I use regularly. And if I get, as I add more, I'll put them in this list. For instance, this graph shows us over the last 2 years, companies contributing to Jenkins, companies whose employees have contributed to Jenkins, have been at a high of 149 and are currently at about 97, a low of 71. So I find the data interesting in terms of individual contributors. We've gone from a high, we've had peaks of 770. At the moment, we're at 610. So the peaks and the valleys are interesting, and this data comes from DevStats now. Eventually, it will come from Linux Foundation's Insights project. Any questions on that topic? All right. That covers all the topics that I had on the agenda. Any other topics that need to be added to the agenda before we close?
Not for me.
All right. Thanks, everyone.